looks Terracid and can make it be Terracid. And Na'vi definitely can be one of those teams.
All right, here we go, folks. You see the map fly through. It is time. It could be the last map, or Na'vi could win it and keep us going. It is Kabul. Helium, Launders, take it away.
Thank you so much, guys. Woo! Going into this potential final map.
No, Na'vi, take my energy.
Yeah, there you go. Send it over. This is going to be that pistol.
Not my skins.
Na'vi on the T side. VP on CT, and it's, you know, different opinions leaning one way or the other, whether it is T or CT side, and I'm a bit onto that T side. As I said, the teams that are really competent on it can do a lot. Flamey dropping down here into that AB connector, trying to get out from this drop room. Guardian Bialy finding frag, though, already. Bialy actually with the double there coming out. Zeus to find Bialy, and now Snacks coming out. So Na'vi finding themselves on top of the situation. 3-1 in their advantage. Zeus with that bomb. Neo about to get caught with that knife out. Still pushing through, though. Has a USP. Let's start with the one tap. No, Guardian will find him. And again, Na'vi starting things off with a pistol here.
Yeah, excellent decisive pistol round from Na'vi. Decided to hit B straight up. Really caught a player moving the back of the side. I think it was Snacks. I caught it off guard. Didn't really expect anything to come out without a full, without flashes or smokes. And it ended up working out really well for them. Dropping dropping late was also really great. And then that left Neo in a 1v3 in the back of the site when they could have, they rotated the bomb through doors to go A. There's pretty much no hope for him at that point. And that's a good, strong start for Na'vi to build some momentum and gain some confidence.
All right, heavy towards B right now. For the side of VP, trying to hold on. Taz has started things off, but sees an Edward to get some kills in there. Snacks hanging up low the drop. Edward having jumped off, but brought in by Pasha. That evens up for a second. Zeus, and Zeus again with a double right there, leaving Snacks all alone in this drop room, going out for the CZ. How much ammo is in that? He's going to have to reload. Turning this into a one if he's very skilled or perhaps a bit lucky. Maybe a two-kill gun, three people to kill. And he's just actually just going to back off.
Yeah, I don't know if they had bought any SMGs on that round, but if they had, it won't be such a big loss. They've still got a couple of Galils, and I'm just kind of looking around to see where the kills are made, just to make sure that they didn't lose anything too expensive. And it looks like they come around from that round pretty clean. Snacks still in a position to actually get a lurk frag, though. It might be one of the spots you would check this rat hole, as I call it.
Nice.
I don't know what you call it.
Vent room,
vent room,
hut, a hut,
okay.
Room, I don't know. It's actually funny, you can shoot through this little hole in that vent without breaking it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, as long as your recoil doesn't touch those vents, obviously, or pieces of sheet metal. Not really a vent, but anyway. 2-0 for Na'vi, very good. Got to get the 3-0, start off here very, very strong.
Yep.
Keep that money on VP, you know, so fragile, forcing them always to, you know, be rebuying on those CT rounds, buy save kind of scenario for the CTs and just dominate here, starting off on the T side. Although, we're really looking to round four at this point, so probably another walk in the park for Na'vi, but you never know. There's a small percentage chance that VP does something crazy here.
Mm-hmm. I think next round we should probably get a listen in just to hear where these players' heads are at. I know we might not be able to understand the language, but even just hearing the emotions could be
yeah, interesting. Just the tone of their voice, how they're communicating with each other.
Yeah, they are cleaning up here. So maybe we got a Turtle Beach team chat on Na'vi next round.
For round four? Yeah, if that can be done, let us know. And it'll be coming into that. There's three. Clean, only losing Flamey.
Yeah, very well played. Lots of money here for both teams. Virtus Pro are going to be buying up. And I don't know if they have the op option, which is something I like to say. Pasha has that 4750, but it decides not to glass cannon. Actually, Neo does pick it up, so they will have him. Will they play 2-3? One thing that you can do with the op is play 2-3, because you can just walk off that long position. Also, set yourself up to get a really easy opening frag and just fall off, because you have a lot of cover. And provided they don't rush lower A, you can always do that.
So
that allow you to strengthen B, which is the hardest site to hold.
We've had a lot of talk about Neo becoming that new primary opponent. It looks like on Kabul, it's shifted the positions a bit. We've seen Neo out towards over at the long A and Pasha going towards B. I wonder if that's just because the op is here and they wanted to get that information out towards middle, or if they have completely switched it up. Let's see. Pasha, does he spot this? He's going to see the head of that player. It looks like he might have if that flash didn't come in. He still may have, but didn't have the opportunity to take the shot. Will he go ahead and give them another peek? I don't know. Oh, flash is coming in from that ally. Almost worked out. He'll spot two of them still trying to hold on to this angle. Smoke coming out. That's going to let them run in, but Pasha taking one down. Now Edward here has got to get that frag, and he does. Three on three, though, as they try to get off this long plant. That is Na'Vi. VP moving in towards the site, and that's actually Bialy. He gets there first and is taken down by Guardian Neo, hanging onto the rock. Can he get the shot? No! Flamey so quick with yet another entry, and now it's Snacks on the lurk! Well, they find him, because he brings down Edward.
Yeah,
it's a one-on-two for Snacks.
Yeah, he's got a great position here. One-on-two, full HP, only has a nade though, no kit. We'll have to find one in the sight of anything. I know Neo has an op to pick up, so if that isn't worthwhile, spot one player on the side of that bomb site, and Guardian actually comes up for the trade, takes him down. That's 4-0, that's the first rifle.
That's a very key round for Na'Vi. If they want to extend this, of course, into that next map, that would be Mirage.
What is your pred, by the way?
I thought it was 3-0. You're going to start trying to call me out already?
I'm just curious. Na'Vi's looking strong right now.
They are.
And I don't want you to falter or anything, but...
Want five maps. Just saying, based on what we've seen.
Yeah.
And here's that buy save we were talking about, right? Whoa. The one buy and the first rifle to save. They're going to go for that quick boost. Grenade, it looks like it will. No, it goes off right on his foot, down to 31. Pasha, though, will find a kill with the CZ. That's going to bring down Flamey Zeus to intercept Bialy as he tries to push through. Snacks in a good spot, going up towards Dragon Lair. Seized, waiting for him.
They knew he pushed, so yeah, just going to get that kill. And now it is 3v3, a very expensive round overall. Oh my goodness, these headshots right now. Taz finds a kill for himself.
He's got the AK.
Yeah, A is definitely the harder site to hold with. Actually, does find an AK.
Yeah, they both have them now. Just no armor is the only thing, but if you get that one tap, if you're in there first with the kill, it will not matter. And let's see, Neo spots one. Zeus, though, getting the, connects those bullets, and Neo just cannot pull that crosshair down. Now it's Taz in a one on two.
With armor, however.
That vent is not broken. And the Molotov coming in, that's gonna make him waste time or force him to go 40. Will go 40, does have the Kevlar here. Coming in 1v1 against Seas, a very, very critical round for this one.
I love this
just backing off. He does make some steps. I don't know if Taz was in the range to hear that. Go through the 1v1 cams.
He took a risk there, push around, got in the ideal.
And he's looking into the site. That is Taz. And Seas is just backing off. He knows what he's planted for here.
Beautiful.
And this is amazing play here from Na'Vi. There are, of course, no kits. So Taz running out of time.
Oh,
that flash delaying him even more. And they don't even have, doesn't even have to spot him to win this. Taz finds the kill, but as we know, it will not matter. And on such low HP, can he even run far enough away from this? Apparently, yes. Taking only 3 damage, he'll survive for the AK. But Na'Vi, 5 rounds now.
Yep.
In a row.
Yeah, they are giving them the treatment, putting on a clinic here. That was a really close 1v1. Super nice play from Seas there in that 1v1. You know, he put the bomb down.
That was textbook.
And pushed around the truck, decided if he comes around this way in the truck, I'm gonna take the duel. If he doesn't, I'm gonna win this round 100% and still put myself in a good position if he does come around the truck to win the duel. So
the lops call for VP. So something not working, and they're gonna try to change it up with this other buy. Neo and Pasha. Neo going in through danger with his Pasha out towards B back in that chicken coop. Let's see if he can put it to any use.
Yeah, this smoke is okay, like at lower A. People throw it a lot, but it's so easy to flash through. Actually, Pasha here, though, on the other side of the map, grabs a frag for the team.
Yeah, the Zeus a little forward there by himself. Let's see if Bialy wants to try to work on through this, go on for that flank. Na'Vi had two holding outside of on T middle. It looks like they are going to work their way into long bomb, moving that way as well.
Neo, full flash, has to fall off. That's a huge positional advantage for Na'Vi. Where Virtus Pro wanted to take control of long.
Whoa, that was a pretty sweet flash. Yeah, Edward's so incredibly blind. Still alive and on full HP. And I don't think he was actually spotted. Seized! Still lurking around B. Will find Pasha. That was that op. Started off with the first kill, and now he's brought down. So man advantage back in favor of Na'Vi here. The bomb once again shifting back to the other site. Tazdo still in drop. He's got potential from this position. Maybe not with the smokes. And someone, of course, can just push that behind him on the other side of the rectangle there. Now going to work away around this site, trying to get those headshots, gets it through the plant, trying to strafe about and bring in that other kill, but now it's going to leave it to just Neo here over through that door. Can he get the shot? He does find one, but Edward able to capitalize on that.
Yep.
And he wants that personal 300. He tries to get the plant real quick.
Yeah. Yeah, Na'Vi actually go and string together another round in a row. Taz actually has a lot of money, I think, due to the fact that he saved that AK, so he's going to be able to drop for his teammate. That's one less Fomis on the board in the midst of this force buy. Yeah, it is barely a force buy. I mean, we have a couple players who don't have the nades that they want, but most people have a smoke, which is going to be a key point for them. They can recycle that smoke along B if they need to, maybe sacrifice one at A that isn't so important, and really cut off any rush potential and delay this until the late round.
So Na'Vi starting off with pretty much that same default setup that they had last time. Two players holding out, watching that middle or long A push, and three over towards B, summit long. And one on the drop. Meanwhile, Taz Bialy doubling up on this drop room. Flash to go up. Does blind them, and a flash in return. This one fully blinding Taz, only taking 20 damage from that. The Molotovs go in. Another flash forces Taz to look over at the wall, and it'll be brought down a result. Flamey getting a kill elsewhere, and Pasha trying to hold on. He's got the long, long angle on the drop room, and Flamey capitalizes on that. 5-on-2 here, and just flawless execution. Na'Vi winning all of the battles, and about to get 7 in a row.
Yeah, absolutely no problem. And this wouldn't be that amazing if it wasn't a stomp in a situation where Na'Vi were down two maps. You know, at being up 7-0 as well does not mean that it's over, because VP have proven in countless rounds so far that they can just change the pace of the game at any moment. Now, Snax is going to be taking a duel at long A. Edward is going to be the man to watch. He does only have 24 HP. He's going to fall off, and that's very wise of him considering that... Oh, keeping that economy high is very good. Whoa,
wow,
but
Neo,
sharpshooter.
Yeah, finding 3 kills on the round, at least making Na'Vi remember that they are mortal. Zeus going to go down as well to Snax. So only Edward to survive, but Na'Vi getting their 7th round here. And starting off, you know, hitting the ground running. If we want to bust out the expressions.
That was a huge save from VP, who wouldn't be able to buy in the situation if not for that. I mean, they could have just had, like, straight up 5 Fomuses, but now they've got an op and quite a bit of nades, I mean, pretty much across the board, just due to those 2 rifles that they saved.
Okay, Pasha back with the op, right? So there's a bit of an adjustment. The first time, I think, this tournament, we've really seen him picking it up, right? It's been pretty much Neo all the time, and now we see him here over in the B site with it. 4 M4s are his supporting cast this time. A couple defuses. Taz is from behind as Na'Vi trying to go for that set play, and it might actually backfire. They've got a couple people on the back lines. VP did push through very quickly. Seized will find Snax, but will they expect? And now
4 and B.
Yeah, there are 4 and B already.
Yeah. This is going to be an A map as they do try to exit the site. Edward jumping over the box to spot for information. And we have Seize holding the flank, but Pasha opens up the duel in this 4v4 with the kill, making it 4-on-3. Neo is still anchoring the A site, actually, so it's 3-on-3 if they want to take these fights, but because they have such favorable positions, they're not going to want to. Oh, Pasha
wow,
goes
Pasha
down on that repeat, though, however, and that might change everything completely.
I thought the first one was there, having connected, but I suppose not. Maybe through the legs, just to the side, and it does go for the repeat. Edward now to find a kill. 3-on-2 for them. A bit low on HP, though, are a few of them in time. Getting low as well. 30 seconds towards that B site. Neo still kind of hanging out there over at A. Now coming in through the connector. Taz does find one. He gets seized. Can he find Zeus on this cross? Still got to get into that site. Firing over this ledge. Try to double peek here, since Edward still has that high position up on the catwalk. He'll drop down now. Only be taken down by Neo. Neo, can he find the both? No, he will get it into the 1v1, however, and it's going to favor Taz. He'll take him down, and VP on the board.
Oh my god. After that, after all of that, they actually do manage to bring it to a 1v1 and win, and I didn't think VP were able to win that, but Taz had them cut off completely, and because they couldn't cut off his head, they couldn't cross the site and put the bomb down, which would have put much more pressure on Neo, where instead he had an easy rotate into drop and a frag to match. So now VP do put a round on the board. They, because of their money, have Snax on just an
MP9
here. But Na'Vi aren't looking any better. I mean, some of these rounds have been close.
Yeah, well, they do have 4 AKs. There's also a FAMAS up on Neo. The Deagle on Guardian, though, that just depends. A bit of RNG with that gun, but a player like Guardian can make it work in his favor. Let's see Taz holding in the window. He's going to be brought down immediately by Flamey. That is something you pre-aim and pre-fire, and it pays off there for Flamey. Getting that early man advantage on the round, as has pretty much been the theme so far. Just that one round, as we saw for VP. Pasha now going to connect with that shot. Can he get another? I don't think he saw that Deagle. Peeks out towards drop. Now hitting a harder shot onto Guardian, so he finds that one. And Bialy still, I don't think, going to be spotted, posted up in that position. And there we go. He'll strike from it. He brings down Seized. Flamey in a 1v4. He'll get one. 3 more to go, and Snax shuts him down.
Oh, yeah. Well played. Yeah, that's 2 in a row in the midst of these 7 rounds that Na'Vi have won. Snax made a really nice play there, pushing through the door, flanking Flamey after he threw the Molotov down in the connector and got that 1K, even though Flamey was put in a position that he was 1v4. Just really good positional play like that from Snax is the type of stuff that wins you games and not just rounds. Now, it is going to be a standard 2-3 right now. It looks like they're going
to
flash through
five
this
mid room.
Whoa, all of VP are flashed, however, as well.
You know, waiting for them, though, at the top of danger. And it looks like at the bottom, it's going to be Snax and Taz that are there. So VP getting another round. That's going to be the third. But another rifle coming for Na'Vi. 7 rounds. Not a bad amount for Cobble. Maybe 7, 8, or 9, probably okay.
That's really not the fear, though, right? The fear is that VP start to make a half
make this,
when
yeah.
he had such a giant
Just like they
lead
did on cash, because VP were down 5-0 on cash.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And they now, made the comeback.
Yeah, now they will be going into the second half as terrorists, and I suppose that makes a difference, but at the same time, they seem to be a team that can be just as balanced in either respect. No difference than Na'Vi, even though there is a difference in structure.
All right, let's see. Pasha still holding out there. He started to kind of hit those shots over here at B. Looks like he'll take a place on that back plat near the bench. Bomb, though, out towards A. 3 people looking to work into those long tunnels. Neo posted in danger, and a little bit behind him we have Snax. But that smoke going to come in from outside of
Pasha
T middle.
Flamey wins that duel.
That's over at B. Yep. Neo, though, awaiting the push and actually back to B real quick. Bialy finding Flamey, perhaps. He hears a noise. Neo, that's over at long A, finding Edward, guarding with the trade out there. Bialy still with the potential to find a kill. And let's see. It looks like they have spotted each other, and Flamey with the op will tank it. So 3-on-2, advantage to Na'Vi. And they need to stop the momentum of the comeback. So this is a very big round here.
Yeah, dropping a Molotov in the door is going to push Taz into the position where he wants to go to drop. And we have Na'Vi moving slowly back towards B. And it looks like they're starting to take off at this point. The site is being taken, and there are 25 seconds left. Taz, last time was a huge problem for them trying to cross the site. Yeah. Now Flamey has a great position. However, he's going to be fighting up or tapping away at Guardian. Guardian, though, finding the better of leaving Snax in that awkward position. And now he's going to be the new threat. Will he be able to take him down? It looks like the bomb will get planted.
There's still a smoke left. Snax kind of thinking it went from behind the site, but that is not the case. One up on Plat and the other kind of working around this rectangle. Let's see what Snax can do. He's going to push around the site. This will open up from the side. Zeus easily going to be able to take that. And there it is. Na'Vi will stop that momentum that Virtus Pro were gaining right there.
Yeah, taking the round into their own hands, securing a much better lead than what would have been 7-4, and kind of solving that problem that they've had in these previous rounds, which was ending the round inside of B. Right, we've seen a couple of rounds where Na'Vi have been able to get 2 kills and drop instantly and fail to close out the round following that. It's been really tough. Now, for the most part, they've been dominant overall, but that's largely due to the fact that they've earned themselves ecos on top of the couple of rifle rounds that they've won. So
Neo back onto that op. He's going to be brought down to 9 and be forced to fall back. And Edward involves a bit of a spray battle in that smoke. It's now going to dissipate, and that'll mean Snax having to fall off. Flamey making sure no one was going to catch him off guard up there as the smoke disappears on top of the drop room. Snax into a bit of a cheeky position, but most of the time just going to get you that 1 kill. Let's see if they won't check it, molly it, or pop flash it. And there it is. Snax actually peeks out, but from Zeus. Going to get there on the trade immediately. 4-on-4 right here. Pasha, there he is. He's going to find Seized, who was that lurk dropping down. Bialy still anchoring that B site. Neo now starting to hit his shots. He brings down Guardian over on the A. Some interesting all chat going on there. And Zeus will fall to Taz. So VP strike right back after the one-off win there from Na'Vi that got them to the 8 rounds.
Tax, Edward says.
Yeah, question mark.
yes, and... well, that was that was Virtus Pro picking everyone apart when they needed to, finding the immediate trades that were coming out on opposite sides of the map at different moments, just holding their angles and hitting their shots. Na'Vi is I was trying to mention though. However, actually now are on an eco, so that's even worse for them. But since they had so much success to drop, right, a very common strategy to do, and just it's not standard. It's not. It might have been. Invented by some team specifically, but at this point it's used by everybody. It's a fast split through connector by getting a couple of players to drop. Now, if you can kill everybody who's going to hold off rotations, can't you take the drop and have like two people go long A and throw their smokes to smoke off upper and maybe crush the site that way?
Yeah,
because
it seems like
they're definitely having more trouble closing out the round in B as opposed to in A, which is, I guess, less tested.
Well, it seems like the smokes make the difference at B. Like getting into the site, crossing, getting the post plant positions, the smokes down or a smoke wall allows you to get into those without, you know, the CTs that have those good angles stopping you to cross, stopping you from getting back up on the platform. Mm-hmm. And that one smoke actually kind of did make the difference in the round where we saw Navi. The last one they closed down, I think that was the round two rounds ago. But VP back again with a little bit of momentum. And the closest they can get here, obviously going to be that 7-8 from their perspective. Navi most definitely want to stop that from happening.
Yeah.
So very important round for them. Guardian, though, is down to that scout only. So scouting four AKs here against the op.
Edward, though. Oh, this Molly is not going to be good.
And Guardian's down.
And they might try to pull up a boost here. He might see that flash, but taking advantage of that turnaround.
And getting the double from it. And Flamey had the triple. Flamey can't find that revenge, and now it's C's left in a 1v5. He did almost have that one in the first map, but not this time. Basha says no, and VP, well, some momentum late in here in the first half.
Oh my goodness. When was it 7-0? Because at this point, it's 6-8. Virtus Pro staging a huge comeback, and once again, like, you know, because there was so much economy built up by Navi, Virtus Pro winning these later rounds means so much. You know, there's no pistol to their name. There's very few ecos overall, I think maybe one in total, and that means VP have just had a dominant performance that has involved a lot of adapting, which really is the best way to play a team, is to adapt to what they're doing.
Snacks doing about 160 damage there. Neo now pushing off, so some aggression here to meet that Tech-9 armor out towards middle. And Taz is going to go down to Zeus, so Zeus with a massive frag for his team evens it right back up to a 3-on-3. Let's see. That's Neo still at long A. He's the only one over towards that site. Bialy still in drop. Pasha way in the back of B. And a ton of time on the clock, so Navi can't think about this one for a while. And quite a bit of nades for them still as well.
Yeah, and you know they use every second wisely. The other thing they have going in their favor right now is they got a ton of utility. Flamey and Zeus both have Molotovs. They both have smokes. Flamey even has a grenade. And C's the only one lurking. Oh my goodness, flicks and finds a kill. Neo goes down, and that is one player off the board. Bialy now, one of the two remaining, is spotted at A site. That's information.
And here they are, Navi, into that A-B connector. Which side will they choose, or will they just get pinched in? And oh, they find Zeus. Wow, Zeus and Flamey just go into their own 1v1s and win them both.
Yeah.
And Navi will take it 9-6 here at the end of the half. Give it up for Navi.
Not bad. Fighting for life in this game. We're at 2-0. I mean, if they don't win this map, it's over. VP win it in 3.
And series point for VP.
Yeah,
so.
And towards the end of that half, honestly, looked like they were starting to become that team that we saw last map. Navi started this half 7-0 and ended it 9-6. Overall, you know, you can look at the ones and zeros and see that that's a positive half. That's not a bad result whatsoever. They're moving into CT side. That might be another bonus for them. It's hard to tell exactly how they see it, but overall, it's a decent result. They've got a lot to prove.
I mean, again, with the close half, with VP taking a bit of that momentum, yeah, they did lose that last one there, but got 6 of the last 8 rounds VP did, kind of making that comeback into the first half. It's going to come down to the pistol again. Like, if VP get this pistol on their T side, they might just be able to close it out here. That's exactly what they did on Cash when they were making the comeback, got into the second half. So
yeah, I guess I was right about that. VP won the pistol.
Yeah, you got it.
I mean, it's just like, yeah, but it was kind of understood, right? Like, you know, it was going to be a test for them playing that T side. But now they're on a map that they like. I mean, even though I think you give the edge to Virtus Pro on this map, and I'm giving it to Navi out of faith, both are very good. Don't really have excuses in terms of not wanting to play it, wishing they had an extra ban and so on. I think are happy to see each other on this map for the most part.
And let's take a look at the box score here. Just looking at all the kills, everyone is really pulling their weight. There's not a lot of difference between anyone's frags. 14-8 between Neo and Snax is the biggest difference, and it's only 11 and then 9 there on Zeus and Edward.
Yeah.
So everyone pulling their weight. This is going to be a slugfest. It's definitely, we both said it was going to be close. So I think we're both right.
Yeah, no
on that front. Here we go, though. End of the pistol round. What do we notice from these buys, Launders?
quite a bit of nades. This looks like a set strat from Virtus Pro. This isn't a map where you can just pull rotations, just run around to other sites really easily. It's one where you're going to have a set way to pull a rotation, and then you're going to execute based off of that rotation, whether you get it or not. And Edward here is going to be chasing.
Whoa!
All the way to Long B is going to find a couple of kills, shutting down this rush immediately.
Yeah, absolutely. Only Snacks was getting out in front of that a little bit, and it's the flawless one for Na'Vi, and there's that momentum now right back in their favor. Beautiful shots from Guardian. I thought it was Edward jumping in that hit the headshot, but
it was actually
Guardian from further back in B. He got them both. Edward was just the distraction.
No, Edward got two kills.
Did he?
Yep.
Well, I thought it was Guardian. I guess I cannot read.
That sucks.
Oh, yeah. It's been a hindrance, all right? Life is hard, not being able to read.
But they do come with that pistol. They've got that 10th round. This is maybe the only map that they've gotten the second pistol, and a huge reason why they might be able to win here. Zeus, though, is going to be the catalyst to that. With this kill, no, Bialy does find the better of him.
Coming out of this window, though, three players here waiting for them. That, of course, was going to end in disaster, and I think it was a nade onto the back of a teammate. Maybe Taz, though, moving forward. Vent is now broken, so he can't get through that. He's going to maybe try to get a sight line through it. He'll catch Seize, but Seize able to turn around with that MP7. Pasha finds Guardian. They did plant the bomb here. That is something very important to note. Pop flash over. That was actually very nice. It will allow Pasha to capitalize on that. And he's got another kill for him. Maybe the player was low, but no. Edward will deny it coming over on that balcony. And the defuse to be had the first two rounds of the second half going to Na'Vi.
Yo, Seize gets killed there. Round's over.
Yeah, that might have been.
That would have been huge. That would have been a point of entry that they couldn't get through. That would have been a gun picked up from Seize. But Na'Vi do edge it out, and that is the key thing to point out, that they do get the round. There's nothing more important here. No style points are going to win you a game at this point. And VP, yeah, even though they got that save, it'll benefit them. Or they got that plan, excuse me. It's only going to benefit them next round. Yes, they are to a save.
Yeah, just going for those P2 pitches. A flash or two here on Snacks can maybe lead to some kills. Take a rifle or two off of Na'Vi. That's kind of what VP are hoping for right now. Maybe even like save one or two of these rifles. We'll see. The real action going to come in the next round, round 19. Flamey getting dinked early on, still alive. Did do about the same amount of damage back there to Neo. And it seems like Pop Flash coming in. Do they have the Pop Flash for this secondary room, this E-box room that Zeus is posted up in? It looks like he's going to be spotted first. They're going to try to push him now, but Zeus able to fall back on that reload.
Yeah, Zeus doesn't need to feel pressure to actually play in the drop at all. I mean, he can just watch the outsides with his teammate. He's Guardian here on the outside. They make sure that no one can jump out window, and then they don't really have to worry about anyone taking it, especially if they think that that's going to be an unfavorable trade. Like, even one for one is not going to favor them. And here he is on the outside, taking that duel with Gully again.
So VP trying to get out. Like, they've robbed the bank, and now they've got to escape. All the CTs just waiting outside, and they're going to be gunned down. And it's Na'Vi to take the first three, exactly what they needed to do to get over to Mirage.
Six separates them. And are we seeing Mirage next?
Yeah, Mirage is the next map. Inferno's coming up last. The full five maps overall probably favor Na'Vi, but right off the gate, it was towards VP.
Right. So if not 3-0, then 3-2.
Yeah, the other way, perhaps.
Yeah, maybe.
But who knows after how we started things off, on the overpass. I don't know if it's even predictable at this point.
Yeah.
It's going to come down to the players, to the aim. Guardian with the op now and going aggressive with it.
Here we have Pasha kind of working that long B. Edward was on the other side of the smoke in the first half and now is going to be taking duels with Pasha. Once again, it seems like they are definite enemies in this matchup, even across maps. It seems like they've had to take duels against each other multiple times.
Yeah, both of them having symmetry on this map too, right? Like playing the same spot on both sides of the map, and so many of the rounds could actually come down just to how their 1v1 turns out.
Yeah,
so I mean,
they're pretty much just like watching each other's demos and seeing how they play this one spot, because getting this lurk frag here is so key. And Edward can play behind that box. I mean, you can use nades here, but actually, Pasha has one, and even though he's behind that box, doesn't want to push him out with the opportunity to kill him.
Looks like some set smokes coming into that A site, just waiting for the one that the CTs have down at the end near those stables. And there's a bit of a wall coming off that SWAT van. Zeus, though, to open up onto Neo. Guardian posted up with the op. And Zeus going to have to turn around now. Going to give that the reload first. Guardian did connect one shot. Na'Vi with the man advantage, 4-on-3. And now two as Snacks falls to another well-placed bullet by Guardian Zeus to move forward, finding Taz, and it is now just Pasha here in that middle room. Going to work up danger and see what he can't find, or maybe just sit in this corner and try to hide.
Completely shut down early on that A aggression. Virtus Pro could not get across the site to plant, could not get in any position to trade because they couldn't find that opening kill. And now this is Pasha to save. 6 seconds remaining.
Yeah, they could kill him at the time.
Yeah, they just need to let him wait. And then they gotta push him. The issue is that Zeus is the closest one to him, and he's only got 20 HP, so there's a high likelihood of him dying on this chase. And I don't know if they want to waste that money, so I guess not. Let him have it.
They will let him have it. Navi are not worried the way they've been playing. They're now only three rounds from winning here on Kabul and getting a map, but still always going to be faced with the series. You know, it's a series point, basically, every map for VP.
Yeah.
And that could be hard to play up against. But on Kabul, great first half. Started off very, very strong here in the second. That's now four rounds in a row. A bit forceful here from VP, so there's a chance they can do it. Let's see how they start off. Quick towards B, but will they slow it down? It looks like with the flashes and the nades coming in, they will. Some set smokes from VP on this round.
Yep, and it looks like Bialy is tossing something out real quick. As there is an armor buy to supplement this habit.
And where are you going to find Pasha? Zeus in a great spot with that AK. Not the cleanest of kills, but he does find two. And now it is Taz by himself.
Wow.
Doesn't even have time to think about the 1v5.
Do we think about a force buy if we're Virtus Pro? Looking at it, yeah, Bialy has enough money. Yeah, that's gonna be AKs.
Still.
That's not bad at all.
Snacks and Bialy with all their grenades. A little limited there on the other three. So Navi now only two away from forcing that next map. Guardian back out with that AWP, of course, and he's going to go out towards Long, backed up by C's. It'll be Edward, Zeus, and Flamey to head off over to B.
Yeah, typically we see teams need to play like 4B, but we've seen like on the pistol, for example, Navi were able to shut it down completely. Guardian opening up the round. Haven't read his name on the kill feed in a long time from that side, it feels like, though. Has had an impact as 17 frags alongside Zeus.
Might get caught off guard. No, it looks like, is Guardian aware that there is someone in danger? He's checking it. He's maybe not sure that they walked out through that smoke, but we can see Taz sitting in that nook there.
Oh, Taz.
Again, he's going to come in and make
sure.
Whoa, Taz. Hey, maybe talking to his team there, trying to pass along some information. He barely reacts to that. And somehow Guardian, he gets lucky enough that Guardian missed that shot. He won't miss that one.
Don't give him two
and
shots.
The round ends very quickly after that.
Things
falling apart. It's 15-6. It is now map point here for Na'Vi.
Yeah, that's probably exactly what happened. I mean, Taz was in full sight of Guardian because he just kind of crept onto the screen. Taz was probably calling something at that moment and got punished for it. And that's why we see, like, that's why it's no coincidence that, like, stats of IGLs are always, are typically lower, depending on how involved you are in the round. Looking at your mini-map is huge. Just even when I'm analyzing, I'm mostly looking at the mini-map, whereas if you're playing, you're straight up looking at your crosshair 100% of the time, so that can't be a disadvantage. Oh, these nades are great! Oh,
this is going to be perhaps a disaster. Oh, no, they've spotted Edward. Taz will take him down. Now it's going to fall onto Flamey to get one kill, maybe some more if he can. No, Bialy hits him. 3-on-3 right here. Zeus coming around very, very quickly. Bialy just expecting it, and now seized all by himself, and VP finding some success here. The first terrorist round about to go their way here in round 22, but is it too little too late here? There's many, many match points for Na'Vi to work with.
Yeah, I don't even know. Seizus just doesn't want to take on the size of the site right now, and I don't blame him. He's going to wait and try to do some economic damage, it looks like, and he has a better chance of getting a lurk frag as opposed to running into the site. Doesn't want to try to bite off more than he can chew, looking for both just in case he could win the round. Knowing that he is going up against a competent team with decent afterplan spots, and we'll hang on to this M4, his nades, and the solace in knowing that he has a lot of money to work with, and a team that's on CT's side that have won the majority of rounds up until this point. But if we look at the half the other way around, we saw Na'Vi have this exact same lead cut short by one loss. Virtus Pro rush B. Rush B is like their answer. They can just do it, and I can't believe I didn't expect that either. I mean, they got shut down the couple of times they tried it. Why didn't they get shut down again?
All right, Seized here in danger, gonna throw that grenade in. If it was a bit earlier, that could have been devastating, but here they'll move past it. Coming up that CT slope already. Seized completely blind. He's gotta find himself behind that wall. That wall's very spammable. Seized still able to get one kill and nearly a second. Taz brings him down, only to be immediately traded out. Zeus here on the balcony, gonna find one and then two right there. It's a 4-on-2, and this looks like it could be it here. Na'Vi gonna take Kabul, or at least they should. Pasha still trying to make some heroic plays. There's an op and an M4A1S, and Pasha gonna be taken down by Flamey as he falls off that balcony. It's all on Neo right now. The GG already coming out of the chat, the offensive one for C's. And Neo will go down. Flamey deletes him with the USP of all weapons for the final frag, 16-7.
Na'Vi still
will
alive.
Force map 4, which will be Mirage.
Oh man. Yeah, now it's getting intense. We see Mirage as a map. Which way did the analysts call it? Which way we're looking at this? We'll probably get their opinion.
It was Hiko that said Overpass and Mirage would go the way of Na'Vi.
Uh-oh.
It was Thorn with just Overpass. And I think if it went all the way, it was 3-1 and 3-2 in favor of VP were the prediction. So going at least 4 and 5 maps. So right on that account we are. Mirage and Inferno are the two that are left. Mirage up next. And that should be very exciting. Both of these teams known at one point as the better Mirage teams.
Yeah, I can see it going either way. Na'Vi known for innovating a lot of the A takes that we see today.
Yeah, that closer wall of smokes on that A side.
They have pinged up that wall multiple times. And are fierce for sure.
So a lot to expect out of this. Again, it's going to come down to probably how it starts. We've had the cash was very streaky to start things off from one team. Cobble extremely, and it was Na'Vi on both sides of it. As VP did, you know, streak a few together to close out on cash. Mirage, how do you feel about the map? Do you think it's one of the more CT-sided maps still left in the pool here?
Which?
Mirage,
I think it was a really weird map where, like, the meta is still, like, developing constantly to the point that, like, you know, there is a Inferno is, like, an 11-4 CT-sided map, right?
Yeah.
It's, like, been like that forever.
At the top level, of course.
Yeah, at the top level. I mean, even in a regular match, like, if you play decently CT and someone plays decently CTs are going to come away with more rounds, right? On Mirage, however, like, you can very easily see a team come away with, like, 9 or 10 legitimate T rounds, and then the other team come back from that and equalize. Like, all the time it happens, and, you know, it's a map that's, like, awkward because it's, like, 70% A takes, 30% mid-control and B or something
like
that.
It is just closer, right?
Yeah, maybe that's why, yeah.
Why hold W longer than you need to close it out? All right, guys, well, that's enough of us up here on the desk. Let's throw it down to the analysts. Again, it's going to, of course, be Scoots, Hiko, and Thorin. Guys, take it away.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Well, Na'Vi has decided to make it a series. Very nice. 2-1. And pretty good stuff. A very good even 9-6 first side, but then, you know, Na'Vi just took it over. I mean, that's the thing. Na'Vi is a team where, like I said, if you're a really good team on this map, even though it's a T-sided map, so there's 9 T rounds, that's very good. It's going to take a lot to match that. So VP is a good team on this map. It's one of their strong ones. They had a chance, definitely. But Na'Vi was just way too good early on. And what's key about this is because they've won in overall such convincing fashion, it really does, even now when you think of it, erase some of the fact of how dominant the series had been up till now. Like, if you're Na'Vi now, you think to yourself, like, if we win the next one, it's even up at that point in time. And in fact, then the pressure's all back on Virtus because they've thrown from 2-0 up. And so they're the ones who are going to be like, oh, we've blown the game. So next map is obviously going to be extremely key. But yeah, to talk more about this map here, it actually wasn't, despite how what a disparity there was in terms of score, it wasn't that bad a game. I mean, you look at the scoreboards here, VP isn't that far behind in kills. They were getting a lot of kills, a lot of bomb plant situations, a lot of 2v2s, a lot of 1v1s. Na'Vi just got all of them at fault. Like, they had the lion's share constantly. You felt like VP never could truly get back into the game. Even when they won some rounds and it got a bit closer, they were always held back a bit.
Yeah, and something that Na'Vi was doing was they would kind of poke both the sites, and Virtus Pro didn't seem like, at least on their CT side, Virtus.pro didn't seem like they knew what was going on, like where they were actually going, and Na'Vi was able to run with it. And on their T side, Virtus.pro, it was kind of the same thing, like Na'Vi just kind of got everywhere, and Virtus.pro had no answer for it. Like, Neo was getting shut down, and the wild card that I called Snacks, he couldn't find his groove.
And again, Na'Vi won both pistols, and we're gonna take a look at round 16, which again, much like the map before, like that second side pistol kind of like set the momentum and ended, you know, this time Virtus.pro's chances to even come back.
Yes, we've got the full rush on to be here. And obviously, when you're that close up, and when we saw this yesterday from Edward, actually, he was in the same position as a cult yesterday.
Yep.
The players who play around the area, their whole job is like getting spray downs all the time, taking two or three people, knowing to fall back, knowing when to push in, and
Edward's one of the better players there. We could see players like Olof M playing that position. When you can shut people like that down on a pistol, Edward is known as like one of the pistol masters, then it's going to be very hard to win on this map because, yeah, it's a T-sided map to a degree, but the CTs get rolling like that, they're already going to be up 3 rounds, you know.
All right, we're going to take a quick commercial break, as we always do between maps. Next map is going to be Mirage. We'll see if Na'Vi can actually tie it up and go 2-2, or if Virtus.pro is going to take the title. Be back after the break.